My dear friends, I come to the questions now. I must say, very ticklish questions and very interesting also. The question that is asked today is the first one: can a Catholic participate in a Hindu wedding if their son or daughter is marrying a Hindu? The second question is it considered a sin for the Catholic to participate in the Hindu rituals? Let me first go with the second question. It's not a sin for a Christian to participate in a Hindu wedding. You know, wedding, marriages, for all the people, it's a happy occasion. Whether it's for Christians, for Hindus, for Muslims, for anybody, it's a lifetime situation. Many people don't get married again and again. And so since it's a life situation, we should also make the people happy. Perhaps India has got such a rich tradition of so many feasts, our Hindu brothers, our Muslim brothers, and our Christian feasts also, that we can call them, we can invite them, we can share our joys with them. So therefore, there's nothing wrong in participating, rather in making yourself present in a Hindu wedding. What is forbidden is the Hindu rituals, or perhaps the rituals of another religion. The ritual means worshipping a particular god of that particular religion. That is not correct. I would say we cannot put our legs in two boots. One is a Christian god, another is a Hindu god. The Hindus have belief and we respect them for their beliefs in particular gods or deities that they have. We also have the Holy Trinity. We believe in the saints, and therefore we don't mix up these two issues. And we say that while it is nothing wrong in participating in a Hindu wedding, perhaps having their foods, giving a gift. I also have visited many Hindu couples, Muslims also. I've also participated recently, 2-3 months back, in the iftar program of the lunch, of the dinner of the Muslims. These are all happy occasions we should. But participating in their rituals is another thing which is not to be done. The first question is, can a Catholic participate in a Hindu wedding if their son or daughter is marrying a Hindu? First of all, when a Catholic is marrying a person of another religion, it's called an inter-religious wedding, for which we need a dispensation from the church. The church does give dispensation for a Christian to marry a Hindu person. And the promise that we ask of the Christian party is that the Christian party, after the marriage, will continue to practice the religion of the Christians, the Catholic party. And also the little promise that they make is they will try to bring their children also in the faith of the Christian party. This is a small promise that the Christian party makes. It's called a dispensation that is given for marriage. And normally in the church, when the marriage is celebrated, perhaps we may not have the Eucharistic part of it, because the Eucharistic means the non-Catholic part cannot receive the Holy Communion, and it becomes embarrassing that the person who participates doesn't participate fully. The Catholic party can perhaps give communion. So in order to avoid these sort of complications, we have the wedding of the Christian and the non-Christian party together, either before the Mass, or a few hours, an hour or so before the Mass, so that if they want, they can participate in the Mass as common citizens, as everybody else. What about the Hindu wedding? We normally do not encourage the Christian party who is celebrating the wedding in the church also to celebrate, have a parallel Hindu wedding. We say perhaps this doesn't look very nice. It's like, once again, as I said, that you want to please two gods or two religious entities, two religious rituals. But in some cases, the Christians perhaps may not have the rituals proper, but there could be a celebration of friends, a circles of family who come together. And surely this joyous occasion of the Christian also celebrating either with a Hindu family or the non-Christian family, I would say perhaps I would tolerate, or perhaps I would say, okay, this is good for us. But to participate, for the Christian to participate in the Hindu rituals, would as good as saying that I don't believe in my own God. I don't believe in my own religion also. The force of circumstance is always there, but then we'd like to advise our Catholics to say that surely when you fall in love, love is blind, we say. We cannot object you to getting married to a non-Christians, but these small implications have also to be remembered, and to see that you do not get into situations which are embarrassing for you and your family. That you participate in the Hindu rituals, which I would say the commandment says, love your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, with all your strength. You can't love two gods with two hearts, with two minds, with two souls as it were. And therefore, we request that you really realize and plan out your weddings in a good manner so that it's a happy occasion for you and for your family. God bless you. May you have a good weekend.